Hey everyone, this is Michael again, and welcome back to the old channel here on YouTube. This, of course, is the gaming channel, and as you already know, I have a video game update to do today. It's been a little bit of time since I had my last video game update, and I've collected an assortment of different games over the time between that last one and this one that I want to show you guys off. Now, at this recording, many of you already know that I have finished The Evil Within 2 and Until Dawn. Now, The Evil Within 2 was a very, very fun game. Loved the game. Really enjoyed it. One of my favorites. And almost kind of sad to see it end. But I just, you know, from what I hear, there's not going to be an Evil Within 2 because the second one didn't have the sales power behind it to produce a sequel. And at the very end of the credits, after The Evil Within 2 goes over, you see the Mobius computer starting up again, so they kind of left it open for a sequel. But apparently there's not going to be a sequel, and I'm kind of glad, because, you know, at least this one ended on a happy note. Sebastian got his daughter, he was reunited with her, they drove off into the sunset, and what better ending can you have than that? I'd rather have it like that instead of like a Dead Space 3 ending where everything falls to fucking hell and the bad guy or the good guys lose, and I just don't want that for Sebastian. The character just, you know, went through so much hell in that game, so I'm glad that he got a happy ending. And that was also my very first live chat game that I did, and that was a lot of fun. I want to thank all of you who came by to say hello and share the experience. That was a lot of fun. I'd like to do that again. Don't know when. But I'm thinking that when Resident Evil 2, the remake, comes out, maybe I'll do a live stream of the very first episode. The only thing I'd have to worry about is timing and, you know, who's at home and all that. But that really, that's kind of a great idea. And I think that's how I'm going to play the first episode of Resident Evil 2, the remake. I'm going to live stream it. And, you know, I'll be playing while you guys are watching. I've never done that before, but that's going to be pretty cool. And Until Dawn, I enjoyed the game. I thought it was very immersive. It reminded me of those old books, those choose your own adventure books, where it would say, like, if you want to do this, go to page 13. If you want to do that, go to page 30. So it was a lot of fun. Basically, other than the Asian girl that was a total bitch, other than her, my two of my favorite characters live. Now, Sam, you remember, if you watch that playthrough at the very end, she does die. And you hear me say something, you hear me remark, I didn't move the controller. I did not move the controller. And I got online and started doing a little research and saying, you know, why did she die? I didn't move the controller. And many people were saying that the problem is the vibrations on the controller. So that makes it appear that you move. So I got killed because of a freaking vibrating controller. And if I had known that, I would have turned the vibration thing off. But anyway, fun game. Sucked that I lost Sam because I really liked her as a character. If Sam had lived, her and the two guys that did live in my playthrough, they were my favorite characters. And I also liked Matt. Matt was a good character. But anyway, had a lot of fun with Until Dawn. I look forward to revisiting that game one day to see if I can change the outcome. But anyway, we have a video game update. I've got some PlayStation 3 games, some PlayStation 4 games, and I believe one Xbox 360 game. Now, this is probably my biggest update with PlayStation 4 games. So I think I have more of those than any other in the update. But we're going to start, guys, so we can get through this. And I also captured a little footage from the games here to show you guys. Possibly to show you guys while I'm talking about the game. But the first one is one that I actually saw this on Rad Brad's channel. He played this quite a long time ago. I had forgotten about the game, and I saw it pop up on Amazon or eBay suggestion, and I went to look at it again, and I thought it looked really, really fun. I really want to play this game. I want to give it a shot and see how it is. Now, I believe I played the very first game of this on the PC when it first came out, but I never finished it. Not because I didn't like it or anything. I don't know what happened. Maybe something else came out that I enjoyed more, and I just kind of put it on the wayside and never got back to it. But this one, you know, I'm really looking forward to playing this one. But this is BioShock Infinite. And have you guys played this game? I I could definitely see myself playing this game in a playthrough because, you know, it looked like it's a lot of fun. And it really caught my attention when I was capturing the footage for it, just looking it over. I didn't play very much of it because, you know, I don't want to be spoiled by what I see before I play it. But it really looks like it's a lot of fun, this game. And I'm definitely going to give it a look. This one even came with a manual, which is always quite nice. Definitely nice when you get a manual. But I'm looking forward to playing BioShock. Next, we have one that, this is a, I was talking to a girl at GameStop, a really nice girl who was talking about PS3 games and some of the better PS3 games, and she brought this game up, and she said it was pretty much a classic. And I was impressed when I looked at the cover that they had William Defoe as one of the characters in the game, Willem Defoe, and I thought, well, it does sound interesting from what she said, but this is Beyond Two Souls. And it's, from what I've seen, what little I've seen of this, it does look very, very interesting. I definitely want to give it a shot one day. I think, you know, all of these games pretty much that I'm showing, there's Willem Dafoe there, even looks like him. But I gotta say that all of these games basically, seem like they'd be good for playthroughs. But Beyond Two Souls definitely looks like a really interesting game. Another game she brought up was one that I'd never played. Now, I did play just a little bit of this just to capture the footage. And it definitely looked different. The control scheme for it was a lot different than what I would expect. Like, you know, guys, I have enough trouble controlling the PlayStation 3 and 4 controllers anyway. Now, this one just shits on all the usual controls that you're used to and does its own thing. And I was just, you know, messing with the controls last night and thinking, what the hell, man? I'm going to have to learn all these. But it's a game that has received quite a bit of praise. And I didn't get far enough into it to see what's going on as far as the story is concerned. But it does look like a really fun game. And I think people consider it one of the PlayStation 3's best games. But this is Heavy Rain. And like I said, from what I've seen, I do think that it's a nice looking game. Looks like it's a decent concept, and I'm looking forward to playing it, that's for sure. And not only did I get the manual in this game, but I also got some little, I don't know what that is. Looks like some little, I don't know what this is, actually. Maybe you guys can tell me. But I want to put it in here. It actually came with a manual. And I believe that I only paid about, oh, maybe $5 for this. So it wasn't expensive at all. But be that as it may, I happened to come across, you know, this is, of course, is the same game. But I happened to come across it again, and it was a director's cut. And I'm not quite for sure, but it says full PlayStation Move support, downloadable content. Okay. So, you know, it's like game companies do, how they rip us off. You know, they'll release the bare bones version, and then they'll release the version that's the gold edition or the game of the year edition. Then they'll put all the downloadable content in it, then expect us to buy it again. So they rip us off, more or less. And movies are guilty of that too. They do the exact same damn thing. They'll release a bare bone versions of a movie, and then, oh, here comes the special producer's cut, the director's cut, and it has all this extra stuff that you didn't get on the other one. So they, you know, they milk us for what they can. But this is a director's cut of Heavy Rain. And once again, I decided that I wanted the downloadable content. And the reason I bought this was because it was really just as inexpensive as the original was. I think I only paid like $5.99 for it. It wasn't expensive at all. Other than a different cover, or background cover. No, actually these are both the same. The director's cut is part of the PlayStation's greatest hit versions. So, yeah, that there's not much difference in either one of them other than the cover. Now, of course, the back is exactly the same. I wish they would just include the downloadable content on all the versions so you don't have to buy that shit extra. It's like Resident Evil 7, which I really enjoyed. They have a gold edition of that game, which I plan on purchasing, where it has all the downloadable content and all that. The only reason I was able to play Not a Hero on that game was because it was a free download. I don't generally buy downloadable content. I like my shit on the disc. So put it on the disc. Now next we got a couple of games. The last two PlayStation 3 games. And these games are, I believe I have one of them for the PC that I never played. And probably never will, because the PC, and not to down PC games, but I've said this before, the only reason that I don't play games on the PC anymore is because it became such a chore to capture the footage. And you know, I'd hit record and then the footage would slow down, or there was just some kind of issue, always some kind of issue. So I migrated to consoles, and I think the sacrifice was that the PC definitely gets better image clarity, better resolution, better graphics. But with the PlayStation and the consoles, it's just easier to record the game footage. So I just kind of went for that. But these are considered two of the best all-time Transformers games. And I was lucky to get them. They're still a little bit pricey, or at least a little bit more pricey than I'd want to pay. But I'm glad to have these. I think between the two of them, maybe I paid about $25. But the first one is Transformers War of Cybertron. And the thing that I liked about this game, I've seen the games before. I've seen several people play them before. And what I liked about them was the mechanics of the game, the graphics, the character design. Now, granted, they don't look like their original G1 counterparts, but they're so close to that that it's not bad at all. It's not like the movie characters where they just do not resemble any of the characters, or at least very few of the characters. But I love the character design, and me being a huge Transformer fan, it's always nice. You know, this is the kind of thing where even if I never played the games, I would still have the games in my collection. But here's the inside of it, really nice. Once again, I'll say it's always nice when you get a manual, but I think the games look pretty incredible, and it would be a shame if they don't remaster these for future consoles, or even the PlayStation 4, and really show off how pretty everything looks. Now the next one is a sequel to the War of Cybertron, and this is Transformers Fall of Cybertron. And once again, we have the same character designs put out by the same company, basically. And I played a little bit of these while I was capturing the game footage. And I thought it was just pretty awesome, really. Pretty awesome. I mean, if anything, from just a little bit I played of the games, I'll say that they seemed a little bit repetitive. But at the same time, they still look like they were a lot of fun to have and to play. But these look pretty awesome too. And I also got lucky on this one too, because it came with a manual as well. Manuals are always nice to have, for sure. So I'm looking forward to playing these one day, just to see how I do. Because guys, you just don't know, I don't talk about it very much, but I'm a huge Transformers fan. Next we have one PlayStation, or one Xbox 360 game in the update today. This is a game that was recommended to me by a really good friend here on YouTube. And I looked up the game. He sent me a message saying, "Hey man, I think you'd like this game." I looked up the game. Wasn't very expensive at all, so I picked it up. It says, a psychological action thriller. This is Alan Wake. And I had never heard of this game. I don't know anything about the game. If anything, what it reminds me of is maybe a Silent Hill game. It seems to have that kind of same vibe as Silent Hill. I couldn't be wrong, but just from the little footage that I did capture of the game. Actually got a manual with it too, which is really, really nice. Not an expensive game at all. Played it a little bit just to capture the footage, and it did definitely have a Silent Hill vibe to me. The problem I'm going to have with this game, though, is that the Xbox controller is totally different than the... I guess you can't say it's totally different, but it's different than the PlayStation 3 and 4 controller, so I'm going to have to learn a whole new controller again. So that's going to be really, really interesting. But as far as I see, it looks like a really, really fun game, and I think my friend was right. I really am going to enjoy playing this game as soon as I learn the Xbox 360 controllers. Okay, now all the other videos are PlayStation 4 games, and I'm going to show these off, guys and girls. The first one is one, it's a genre that I don't really play very much of, and the reason, you know, it's like a Call of Duty games, World of War, or is it Modern Warfare, all those kind of games. I don't really play those games at all. I don't know, it's just something about, you know, shooting other people online. I mean, I can see where it's competitive and all that, but I just I just like, you know, that sci-fi setting or that horror setting. I'd rather shoot monsters and sci-fi things and stuff like that. Just I never really got into the whole craze of online playing. You know, a lot of people play the games just to play online and battle each other, which is fine, but I've just never really been into that a whole bunch. But I bought this one. If you follow me on Twitter, I had mentioned that I picked up this game and why I picked up this game and all that. By the way, if you want to follow me on Twitter, just look up Michael L. King. And I picked it up for him. A family member came over, wanted to play it, picked it up. We did not get to play it the first night at all because the update files were so huge, and I think the server was overloaded, that it took basically 8 hours before the game updated itself. More on that too over on Twitter. But anyway, the game is Call of Duty Black Ops. And this was basically the first time I ever played a Call of Duty game. And my friend Jeff, who was a big fan of the Call of Duty games, you know, I'm like, hey man, I got Call of Duty, you know, you want to give me some pointers on how to play it, see how I feel about it? And he was just like, you're not going to like it, man, you're not going to like it. But anyway, he ended up, you know, we ended up doing a little multiplayer online. He custom made a level, you know, that was easier. The zombies weren't as fast, or at least the zombies in this game. The chests were open already, I could upgrade easy. He made this kind of tutorial level for me to learn and teach me some stuff. And I did fight, you know, zombies and monsters and tigers. And it wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be. I mean, I did enjoy it. It's not something that I just want to leap into and play again. But overall, I can't say that I definitely didn't hate it. It was okay. It was an okay experience. But that's Call of Duty Black Ops. Now, I'm sure if there was a Call of Duty 5 coming out, which it probably will eventually, I probably would not pick it up. Next, another game here for the PlayStation 4. This is one that I'm looking forward to playing. And been wanting to own this for a long time, but just now got around to buying it. It's almost a role-playing game. And from what little footage I've captured, I did enjoy it, planning it a little bit, but it's Horizon Zero Dawn. And like I said, I did enjoy the capture of the footage. I enjoyed planning. It was fun. This is definitely, once again, another game that would be really, really good for a playthrough. Here's the back of the case here. I almost dropped it. But it looks like it's going to be a lot of fun. Here, Horizon Zero Dawn. I like the... Is this looks Capcom? Tough,
but I can get through.
Well, I don't see... This is Guerrilla. But, yeah. But, I don't know. It looked incredible. The graphics looked incredible. It looked like a lot of fun. And, yeah, I remember this now exactly. I was capturing so many games last night that I'm getting confused. But, yeah, this one starts out where the girl is a little kid. Little baby, actually. But, you know, the graphics were really stunning. Just a beautiful game. Just very, very beautiful. It just looks like one of those games that I'm just really going to have a lot of fun with. Looking forward to playing that one. Next one is one that's a sequel, actually, or actually a prequel to Until Dawn. And I was having such a good time with Until Dawn that I came across this prequel accidentally and thought I'd love to play a prequel to Until Dawn, as long as they make it like Until Dawn. But unfortunately, the game is The Inpatient, and what I failed to notice before I purchased it was that it says you'll need these, and it looks like a PlayStation VR and some other thing, but I don't have any of that stuff. And I ordered this online, so I really wasn't paying attention to what it was saying up here, which I should have, but I didn't. Reviews on this game were very, very mixed. A lot of people didn't like it. It came and went. A lot of people didn't even know it existed. But it takes place at the sanitarium in the game, and I guess it might show how the creatures became to be or something like that. I'm not real sure, but it's worth the play. I mean, as soon as I can get the VR equipment, I'm going to give it a shot. It'd be nice if you could just play it without that, but I did not capture any footage to this, guys, simply because I don't have the items you need to play it. Next one. Now this is the this is the Capcom one, and I captured footage too. This is Monster Hunter World, and this is also another game that, surprisingly, to my surprise, came out put out by Capcom. I did not know they were the ones behind this game, but I had seen this online for quite some time now, and I just thought it sounded really, really interesting, and I wanted to pick it up. So now I have Monster Hunter, which is once again Capcom. It's a did a great job. It's a beautiful game with some really interesting design factions to it. The monsters look really great. This is one that I'm going to give a shot and see what I think about it. It looks like it's going to be a lot of fun. Once again, I got to say, it'd probably be great for a playthrough because, like I said, it looks like it'll be a lot of fun. Next is a game that a lot of people were not impressed with. This was a game that people pretty much dissed and said that it's just like playing a QuickTime event movie. But I don't know. I've never played it. I knew when it first came out, I wanted to buy it. It was a little pricey when it first came out, so I ended up not buying it. But now, you know, $5, had to pick it up. And I gotta say, guys, from the footage that I captured, it seems like it's gonna be an interesting, fun game. I could be wrong. I mean, I only played a few minutes of it. But I definitely want to give it a shot because it just looks like it's gonna be a really good game. This is The Order 1886. And the funny thing about this is when I opened it up, look what's inside of it. There's a preview, Summer 2015, Until Dawn. So we'll keep that in there. But from what I've seen of the game, it looks like it's going to be quite a fun time playing this. I don't know. Maybe it's an underrated game. Maybe it's better than what most people say. But I definitely want to give it a shot. I think it, you know, deserves that much. Definitely worth $5. Hopefully. Next, we have a Lord of the Rings game. And I did not capture any footage from this game. But it's one that, this one actually is the gold edition of the game. It has the downloadable content all in it and all that stuff. I'm a huge fan of the Lord of the Rings games, and this actually feels pretty heavy. So I think this might be have a metal case to it. But this is Middle-earth Shadow of War. I don't think this was as well received as the other Lord of the Rings game, Shadow of Mordor. But still, this one got some pretty high praise. And like I said, I'm a sucker for the Lord of the Rings games and films. So this is just one that I had to add to the old collection. Looks like it's going to be fun to me. There's the back of it. I'll have to play one of these one day. But there you have it. Shadow of War. Next, we have an indie game that I came across on YouTube. Someone was playing it, and I took a look at it, and it reminded me of the old PC games with the just beautiful, colorful graphics and the kind of animated looking characters that look more like they're suited for a cartoon instead of, you know, based on just real life anatomy. But it looked like a fun game, and I liked the description of the game. But this is Silence, and I actually believe that this is a game that was released in the UK and maybe even designed in the UK, but it looks like it's going to be a lot of fun from what little I played of it. It's a has gorgeous graphics in it, gorgeous graphics. I mean, you know, the footage I captured is nowhere near on the level of the actual graphics of the game, because from what I've seen, you know, further on into the game, just from what I've seen on YouTube, the game is just a beautiful game, and I'm looking very forward to visiting this game and having some fun with it. I think it would make a wonderful playthrough as well also. But Silence looks like a lot of fun. Okay, two games left, and I can pretty much lump these both together because one is a collection and one is a sequel. Well, the collection, there's sequels in the collection, but I've got the actual ending game, or at least the latest game. Now, this is a game series that have been out for quite a long time. I've never played any of these games, and a lot of people have asked me to play the games. And they're right up there with the Fallout games as far as, you know, requests. I've gotten a lot of people to request that I play the Fallout games, and I don't think I own any of the Fallout games. No, not on the PS3. No Fallout games. Not on the Xbox 360. No Fallout games. So I've never played a Fallout game. And speaking of Fallout games, my friend today, Kalen, was telling me that he just finished Fallout, I believe it's, is it 4? Fallout 4 or 5? The latest one. I think it was, maybe it's 5. But he said he just finished the game last night, that it was great. He loved playing it. So I've got to give the Fallout games a shot one of these days and see how they are. But anyway, back on topic. This is a game series that I have yet failed to play. There's been 4 games in this franchise so far, and I haven't played any of them. And I bought this collection. I had them on the PlayStation 3, but then I thought, well, this is all lumped in the one collection, and it's on the PlayStation 4, and it's been remastered, so I may as well play them from this. But this is the Nathan Drake Collection Uncharted. And like I said, I have never played these games, but I think I owe it to myself to play these games, because, I mean, I think these games might be quite a bit of fun. And a lot of people have said they're just like the Tomb Raider games, except you have a male star in the game. So that sounds pretty interesting. Definitely worth giving a shot, because I'm not a huge fan of the Tomb Raider games. But here lately, I've seriously been thinking about playing a Tomb Raider game. And finally, in the video game collection, we have Uncharted 4: A Thief's End. And I did capture a little footage from this, and from what I saw, I enjoyed it. I mean, granted, I didn't get anywhere as far as, you know, that far into the game and all. As a matter of fact, when I was capturing the footage and playing the game, I couldn't even hear what the characters were saying or what was going on, because my better half was in bed asleep and I just didn't want to make a lot of noise. But the little bit that I did witness and play, it seemed fun. So, you know, that was I'm also, you know, like, when somebody says, I want to see you play Uncharted 4, if this is the fourth game in the franchise, it's hard for me to start with number 4, because I'd rather go back and play number 1 and then work my way up. So if you make any suggestions about playing a game like Fallout 5 or whatever, it's just hard for me to start at that point. Unless the games are on PC, most likely I would look up to see if there's a collection of them and then start with that collection as far back as I can. But like Uncharted 4, I would love to start with the early ones. I would start with the early ones because I just want to experience it. But anyway, there you have it, boys and girls. My video game update for this week. Still haven't decided on what playthrough I'm going to play yet. Thank you guys for all your great suggestions. Most of the games that you did suggest, I do have. I don't know. I'm still looking it over. Seeing what I'm going to do next. Not for sure yet, but kind of nice to actually take a break from playing a game now and being done with two. So I don't know what's going to come after this. I'm still, you know, thinking about it, and we'll see. But as always, you'll be the first to know. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I will see you all in the next video.